Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about the problem of why not being controlled with integral action and how to fix it. To begin with this topic, we define an integral YNOP as a situation in PI-ID controllers where a large change in set points occurs and integral term accumulates a significant error during the race. Therefore, it creates an excess in overshooting, as we can see it in the image. Now we are seeing how does it look. So here we have a set point change that goes to 0 to 1. So at the beginning we have a peak of 2. But as the times go on, it starts to stabilize in 1. Those peaks, what it creates is that the actuator quickly starts to saturate, and in other words, the actuator reaches its maximum value. That also makes that the integral part shoot up, as we can see here. And also the integral part continues saturating as the actuator as long as the error keeps going positive. When the error starts to become negative, the integral part starts to decrease the saturation of the actuator, and it has the same behavior over and over until the signal stabilizes or the error also stabilizes. As we can see it, it creates a problem, so we are going to analyze some ways to prevent the wind-up. The first method and the easiest was the set point limitation. This method, what it does is that it limits the whole system to a value previously established. The problem with this method is that it cannot be implemented in a long time applications. The next method was the incremental algorithm. This method, what it does is that turn off the integral part during peaks, where it can't create the wind up. With this, it searches that the value oscillates somewhere near zero. But the problem with that is that in the first part of the signals, the integral part doesn't actuate to help the whole system of the PI-ID control. Finally, the last method to see is the path calculation. For the path calculation, it's necessary to follow some steps. The first is the output saturation. The second one is the recomputing of the integral part. The third one is giving a new value to the integral part where the saturation limit is. Finally, the fourth one will be obtain the new time constant created by the new loop system. Here we can see a normal PI-ID control system. Here is stated the derivative, the proportional, and the integral part with its components. All of them are connected to a summary function at the end that creates an output signal called B. This signal enters to the actuator, and the actuator gives another output signal called U. What the back calculation does is that we create a new signal error with subtraction of the output of the actuator and the output of the PI-ID controller. With this subtraction, when U is greater than B, we are going to have a positive error, and in the same way, when B is greater than U, we have a negative error. This new error is divided between the new time constant, and all of this is returned to the system through the integral part. This will make that the integral part will be recalculated, bringing the value nearer to zero. Talking about the new time constant, it's necessary to find one that avoids oversaturation. So the best way to achieve it is to select one that is bigger than the derivative constant and smaller than the integral time constant. But the best rule to find it is that the new time constant is equal to the square root of the new multiplication between the derivative and the integral constants. Finally, we see how does the path control graphs look like. First of all, the integral part doesn't have an excessive integration. Then, the actuator can easily desaturate. And finally, the response have a smaller overshoot. So thank you for your attention and have a nice day.